Good afternoon, grade 9 learners. My name is Jacques Botha, and I will be responsible for today's natural sciences lesson on the reactions of acids and bases. And we're also going to look at some applications of neutralization reactions in the everyday life. First, we're going to look back a little bit and revise and just see what neutralization reactions are. When you read here together with me, you'll see it says a neutralization reaction is a chemical reaction in which an acid and a base react to form water and a salt. This is very important. We must know the definition of what an acid is, what a base is, and then also what, or we all know what water is, but also what a salt is. And if in terms of revision, when you look at what an acid or the properties of acids are, just very shortly, we know that acids taste acid. Now, it's got a sour taste. And of course, this doesn't mean you must now take a bottle of acid and taste on it. But the weaker acids like vinegar and citric acid and those which we use in our kitchens, one can taste them, and they're all sour in taste. Then the pH level of acids, all of them, are below 7. Right, 7 we know is neutral, and below 7, that's the range in which we find acids. And the lower this value becomes, like in 4, 5, 3, 2, and eventually 1, the stronger the acid normally is. Then, litmus is an indicator. I know you've learned what an indicator is already. And an indicator is a chemical substance that changes color depending on if the substance is in an acid or in a base. And litmus is the most simplest one that we use in the laboratory. And we know litmus paper turns red when it is in an acid. Properties of bases. Bases has got a bitter taste. Then the pH level range in which bases are found is greater than 7, so above 7 up to 14. And then this indicator litmus turns blue when in the presence of a base. Then a neutral solution. The neutral solution is the water and the salt. This together forms a solution. And one of the most important property of a neutral solution is that the pH is not in the acidic range, it's not in the basic range, but it's exactly in the middle, and it is at 7. Now here the big words, or the capital words in red, is a general equation for a reaction of acids, and this is in words. An acid plus a base give you a salt and water. And of course, this solution is neutral. A salt in water has got a pH of 7, and that's always like this. Then moving on, now we're going to look at specific acid-base reactions. And the first one we're going to look at here is when a metal oxide reacts with an acid. It says here, when an acid reacts with a metal oxide, the metal oxide acts as a base. So the metal oxide, which you see here in the equation, is the base. It's going to react with the acid, and again, it's going to form a salt and water, and this is a neutral solution. We know that. As it's been written here, is the general word equation for a metal oxide reacting with the acid, forming the salt and water. Then when it's written, in terms of chemical formulas, and this is a balanced chemical equation, you can actually look at the numbers or the coefficients before the different chemical substances, and you can count in terms of balancing to see if the same number of atoms of each type is on the left or the right side of the equation. But that's not what we're going to do today. Let us rather just look at the equation. We can see hydrochloric acid, which is the acid, reacts with magnesium oxide, which acts as the base, and it forms, on this side of the equation, it forms the salt, which is magnesium chloride, plus water. This is the chemical equation. Now, intentionally, this word acids, it's got a red color. So it tells us this acid is in this very low pH range. It's here in between 1 and 0. So it's a strong acid, right? It reacts with a base. And when we look here at our pH range, we can see that it's got a purplish color. So it's here towards 13, 14 magnesium oxide. And when the acid reacts with the magnesium oxide, it forms the salt and water, and this two together, both are green. So this is our neutral salt solution, which is at it occurs at pH 7. And then the same equation, just written in terms of words, hydrochloric acid plus magnesium oxide. This is an acid plus a metal oxide gives metal chloride or the salt plus water, and this is our word equation. Right. The picture here, friendly picture shows you when you add an acid to a base, a neutralization reaction takes place. The product is salt and water, and the green color here at the bottom of this Erlenmeyer flask is green, telling us that it is a neutral solution. Right, moving on. Then metal oxides are basic oxides that we've learned. If you remember that reaction that you've done a couple of sessions back where magnesium metal burned in oxygen and it formed magnesium oxide. And that magnesium oxide, when you dissolve it in water, it forms an alkaline solution which can be tested by an indicator. And it's a property of metal oxides, that all metal oxides, irrespective of the metal, forms basic oxides, and when it's dissolved in water, it's alkaline solution. Looking at specific one, we had this one, magnesium burns in oxygen. That was one of our prescribed experiments to form magnesium oxide, which is a base. You can see here, this is magnesium metal. Reacts with oxygen. This is a combustion reaction to form magnesium oxide. And when you take this magnesium oxide, which is already a base, and you let it react with hydrochloric acid, it forms the salt on the side, magnesium chloride plus water, and this is a neutral solution. Then this magnesium oxide, as I explained earlier, if you, instead of directly let it react with hydrochloric acid, but if you first dissolve it in water, typically you do that while you do the experiment when metals are reacting with oxygen or the combustion reactions. You take the oxide, this magnesium oxide, and you dissolve it in water. Then it forms magnesium hydroxide. And when this magnesium hydroxide, when that, or the magnesium hydroxide, obviously it's also it's now an alkaline solution. And when you test this with litmus paper, pink litmus will turn blue in the presence of magnesium hydroxide. But when you take this magnesium hydroxide and you neutralize it by letting it react with hydrochloric acid, which is an acid, it gives you exactly the same product as when magnesium oxide reacted with hydrochloric acid. Also, it's a salt and water, right? In yellow here, we know that magnesium oxide is a basic substance because it is able to neutralize an acid. So whenever any substance is able to neutralize an acid, you know, turning it from an acid so that the acid loses all its acidic properties, and eventually turning into a neutral solution, in this case a salt solution, then you know the substance which reacted with the acid must, of course, be a base or then basic. Right, and this I'm going to do very quickly. Learners, there won't be questions on this. In this year's syllabus, this is excluded, but it links with the previous slide. We had the magnesium hydroxide. This is an alkaline solution. When this magnesium hydroxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, its neutralization reaction, and it forms the salt, magnesium chloride. That's magnesium chloride in water then. So right, grade 9 learners, now it's your opportunity to answer a few quiz questions. Take your time and do your best. Enjoy. So right, grade 9 learners, now it's your opportunity to answer a few quiz questions. Take your time and do your best. Enjoy.